I would like to tell you about sociolinguistic. Sociolinguistic is divided into six contents. The first one is basic concept. Second one is sociolinguistic study materials. Main concept is sociolinguistic methodology in sociolinguistic language in contact and important other important language concepts. First one is basic definition. In basic definition, we can see that the differences between linguistic and sociolinguistic. As you can read, linguistic is the scientific study of human language meaning, form, and context. And the sociolinguistic is the study of language in relation to society. It means that linguistic is just a study of human language meaning, form, and context, but in sociolinguistic, you will study the study of language but in the relation in your environment. And the second is sociolinguistic study material. The first one is variety of languages. Second one is the terms, dialect, sociolect, idiolect, and register. The third is variety of raw and non-standard. The variety of English language. The fifth is language boundary is not discrete. F is problems with biology, maturity, and diglossia. And G is verbal and non-verbal communication. H, events ever code and mixed code. I is speech scenes. And J, planning language. Here are the differences between dialect, sociolect, idiolect, and register. The first one is dialect. Dialect is refers to a variety of language that can be signaled the speaker's regional or social background. For example, it's Australian dialect, Indian dialect. In Indonesia, is so have the different dialect from the other country because that's the social background of that country. And the second one is about sociolect. Sociolect is a variety of language associated with a social group, such socioeconomic class and ethnic group. That's about the sociolect. And here about the register. The register is a variety of language used for a particular purpose in a particular social setting. For example, it's about English journal. The data, that's the variety of English language. You can see that the old English is have the biggest percentage is about 72.9%. And last about the differences between verbal and non-verbal communication. Verbal communication is the exchange of information by words, but non-verbal communication is the exchange of information but with less cues. It means that verbal communication is that you say something or you write something, it's the information is exchanged by words, a lot of words that you can say in verbal communication. But in non-verbal communication is the exchange of information, but the word is not too much, so you just communication with the clue of your body or anything else. And the second one is about the verbal communication has less change of confusion and misunderstanding the message. But non-verbal communication has more change of confusion and misunderstanding the message. It means that verbal communication it has less change without misunderstanding. You can understand what she said or what he said about the message, and you will not misunderstanding in verbal communication is more less, but in non-verbal communication it's more change for you to have have a misunderstanding of the word of the clue. What clue that he said to you? The message that he tell to you, you know about it. But and the last is about the verbal communication leads to prompt interchange of information, and non-verbal communication can take more time. It means that in verbal communication is from you that it's fast that you have the message. In verbal communication, you will accept the message very fast because you know exactly what the message is. And in non-verbal communication, it can take more time. Why? Because you can't accept it, accept the message fast, very fast. It's very different from the verbal communication. So thank you. That's for me. The next material is from Rustika Ayu.
What is this minimal phrase? Minimal phrase is the words that are pretty nearly a single sound, usually in the meaning sound. For example, the word spiny is simple noun with heidi, and paw with paw, and fang and hang, fang and hang.
Today and
is incomplete time. What is time? Style in the most general sense refers to the distinctive way of speaking or writing. People adopt different styles in different contexts. The first is casual style. Casual style, this type of speech is difficult, if not impossible, to execute because of the observer's paradox. And beside that, the interview style, it is when an interviewer can finally get a more casual speech from the subject. Okay?
Next is a language in contact, and in language in contact there are five, divided into five groups. But the first is vernacular language, the second is lingua franca, the third is pidgin, the fourth is braille, and the last is diglossia. The first is about vernacular language. As we know that vernacular language is a first language multilingual community and especially in formal context and informal function. And vernacular divided into three components. For the first is uncodified or unstandard beside a variety, and the second is the way is occurred. For example, we always use it in our home. And the last is about circumscribed function. And vernacular is the most lingual variety in a person's linguistic importance, and it suit for everyday interact and should use in our lingua franca. Lingua franca is a language of reader community, or we can say that a lingua franca is a language used for communication between two people whom has a first language is different or dominant language. And the third is about pidgin. Pidgin is a language having non-native speakers. Pidgin developed as a means of communication between people who don't have a common language, and pidgin is two groups with a different language communicating in a situation where there is also a third. And the last is about crowd. Crowd is like a pidgin that has become the first language of a new generation of a communication of speakers, and first arise when a pidgin become mother tongues. This according to Ortizzo 1994. And then the process of pidginization here, or communication or simplification of language for the first is reduced in morphology, the second is reduction in syntax, and the third is reduction in pronunciation, and the last is extensive borrowing of words from local mother tongue. And the process of creolization including two part also. For the first is expansion of morphology and syntax, and the second is regulation of phonology, and the third is increasing function, and the last is increasing vocabulary. And for example is Hanyuan Pidgin English, super spreaded, and the last is Hanyuan Crow English is subtrends. And the next, in language also has an important part in language when we are speaking, when we are talking about, and then when we are discussing about. And for the first is about slang. Second is jargon, idiom, dialect, official language is a language, and global language, standard language, and the last is vernacular language that I said before. And the first is about slang. Slang is a very informal language, as we know. For example, walk, slang for awakening, as in being made aware of social injustice. And the second is jargon. Jargon is a type of a shorthand between members of a particular group of people. For example, in Indonesia, always say BTW. It means by the way. And then the last example from CYA. CYA, it means see you, for saying when we are going to say goodbye to someone. And the third is about idiom. Idiom is a hidden nation to do or say something exactly right, and then to express something to people by the other language but has the other definition that make the other people understand. And the fourth is dialect. Dialect is the language used by the people of a specific art, class, and dialects. This race, I mean, or any other group of people. And the fifth, official language. Official language is a language that is a given, especially by particular country, state, or other jurisdiction. The sixth is about global language. Global language, people of English, the international language, right? English of business, English for economy, English for academy. We can call it a global language by using, people often call English is the international language. And the second, the last one, the second one is standard language. Maybe the defined header as a language policy used by population or public host. And the last one is about particular language. Particular that say I said before is the native language or the native dialect of the specific population that we always use in our daily activity.